board.
I'm bored.
I'm the chairman of the board.
Me too.
I'm a lengthy monologue.
What should we
I'm
do?
I'm living like a dog. I'm bored.
I don't know.
For myself, sleep at night. For myself, broad daylight, cause I'm bored.
Blah.
Just another slimy board.
Want to rake him?
Yeah. That's cool.
I see two at once.
Do you think it'll make it all the way down?
I don't know. Well, I made one. Well, looks like the stairs are far apart.
Make it down the slam?
I don't know. Whoa, crash. Well, it kind of did. Whoa, well, it did. Come look. What?
Right back here.
Whoa, try it again. Almost.
After spending the afternoon seeing all of the things we could do with a slinky, we wanted to know more. Here is a great book we found. Gilbert Ford's The Marvelous Thing That Came From a Spring. Richard James was a dreamer, but in 1943, the United States was at war. Richard had to support his country and his family, so he worked as an engineer for the United States Navy in a shipyard in Philadelphia. His assignment was to invent a device that would keep fragile ship equipment from vibrating in choppy seas. Richard tried all kinds of springs, but nothing was working. Then one day, a torsion spring fell from the shelf above his desk. Its coils took a walk. And so did Richard's imagination. This spring might not work for the Navy's ships, but Richard knew he had stumbled onto something. What was it? After work, Richard rushed home and showed his wife, Betty, the floppy spring. They gave the spring to their son, Tom, who let it go from the top of the stairs. The family watched in astonishment as it walked all the way down. I think it's a toy, Richard marveled. Betty thought so too. She also thought if they wanted to share their discovery with the world, they needed to figure out what on earth to call the thing. Betty thumbed through a dictionary for 2 days, underlining words. Nothing sounded quite right until she found slinky, meaning graceful and curvy in movement. Slinky also sounded like the swish and clink of the spring's coils in motion. It was only a name, but it was just right. With one word, Betty thought she could transform this spring into Slinky, a one-of-a-kind thing. Richard and Betty wanted to produce a lot of Slinkies, but they did not have the money to do it. So Richard sprang for the bank and took out a $500 loan to have 400 Slinkies made. Once they arrived, Richard brought his invention to every toy store in Philadelphia, but no one wanted it. Was the James' idea a flop? Finally, he tried a large department store called Gimbel's. Gimbel's showed as little interest in the toy as the other stores, but Richard begged the manager to allow him to demonstrate how it worked to the holiday shoppers, just once. And so, on a stormy night in November 1945, with Christmas just weeks away, shoppers poured into Gimbel's. They were searching for the next great toy, and Richard was ready. He placed the coil at the top of the ramp he had built and scanned the store for Betty. Where was she? Betty was still pacing back and forth at home. She was afraid no one would want the toy. Just in case, she asked her friend to pose as an excited shopper and gave her a dollar to buy one. But Richard was unable to wait any longer, so he took a deep breath and let the Slinky go. When Betty finally arrived at Gimbel's, there was no need to pretend to love the toy. All 400 Slinkies had sold in 90 minutes. The Slinky was a hit. War ended that same year, and the troops returned home to marry their sweethearts. A baby boom soon followed, and demand for the Slinky skyrocketed. So Richard dreamed up an even bigger idea. He used his engineering skills to build a machine that could coil 80 feet of steel wire into a Slinky in 10 seconds. While Richard made the Slinkies and drove the delivery van, Betty kept the business running smoothly. She frantically filled orders, sent and collected payments, and hid their profits in a roasting pan below the basement. Soon, there was more business than the Jameses could handle by themselves. Richard and Betty built a factory and hired 20 people to work for them. At last, they were able to spin out enough Slinkies for every child in America to have one. Today, the Slinky still inspires kids of all ages and all across the globe to play. It took the teamwork of a dreamer and a planner to turn an ordinary spring into a truly marvelous day.